Hi, my name is Gene Alpert. I'm a senior analytics specialist with AWS Enterprise Support. And today in Analytics in 15, we'll be talking about improving search relevance with Amazon OpenSearch service. So what is search relevance? Generally speaking, a user has some thought or idea. That user will enter some keywords. Search engine takes those keywords and produces some results or outputs. The user's intent may or may not match the top results, and whether this document, database, or product search, the goal is to improve the match between the user's thoughts or ideas and the results returned by our search engine. So what could be impacting the match between a user's input and our search engine results? Could be keyword quality, search algorithms, indexing quality, thought transcription, or even document quality itself. Search relevance really is the question of how can you reduce the time spent looking for something while improving the returned matches. Fortunately, there are multiple approaches to improve overall relevance. Let's start at the base layer. At the base layer, we have Apache Lucene, which has its own set of tools to help us deal with text. There are multiple steps to analyzer, things like a character filter to remove or replace specific characters, accents, spaces, etc. A tokenizer, which will then split a string into its constituent keywords, and a token filter to take care of things like upper and lowercase, stemming, and things of that nature. There are, of course, also language-specific analyzers for languages like French, German, Italian, Japanese, etc., and maybe even domain-specific analyzers, which are especially useful if you're searching through text that's specific to a particular industry and has its own set of jargon. It's important to note that in Apache Lucene, the score for a given match is unbounded. Unbounded meaning it has no upper or lower limit. And this is naturally a problem because that means that the search score for a given term is only relative to the specific search being performed and cannot be compared to other searches across other data. The first approach we can use is to improve the user input. We can use suggestors for content-specific searches. Instead of the user having to know exactly what he or she is searching for, we can suggest possible searches based on our indexed data. In OpenSearch, you can use one of the two approaches for this. Use the search as you type field type for general set of suggestions to automatically create a set of n-grams for a field, or you can directly use n-grams or edge n-gram. Both of these field types are kept in memory for fast response. This means that when your query comes in, the coordinator node can read directly from memory and reply directly with. Then we can look at ML-driven or machine learning-driven results re-ranking, also known as the Learning to Rank plugin. The Learning to Rank plugin is internal, or you could use an external re-ranking program to achieve similar results. Learning to Rank has the following basic process. Create a judgment list and apply grades to documents for a specific set of keywords. Then identify the document features for a ranking function to use. These can be document fields or even keywords, field match scores like title score or description score. Then you log feature values. These are the BM25 relevance scores for the individual features of each document that are added to the judgment list. And then you create a training data set, select a ranking function model to use, like XGBoost or LambdaMart, and then deploy to OpenSearch Learning to Rank. Continue to test, retest, and retrain your model as needed. Next, let's explore semantic search. First, a little bit about the K Nearest Neighbors plugin. K Nearest Neighbors, or KNN, extends beyond the OpenSearch or Lucene engine and uses vector space. We use relationships, that is to say, each document field receives a vector calculated and assigned at indexing time. KNN is non-parametric, which means there is no assumption of any sort of regular data distribution. Given an input vector, KNN calculates the approximate distance between the vector and then assigns the points which are not yet labeled to the class of k-nearest neighbors. This is a lazy algorithm, which means it does not need any training data points for model generation. All training data is used in the testing phase only. And nearest neighbors are calculated using cosine similarity or Euclidean distance. The KNN plugin is also how image search works. Images are vectorized at indexing time. The vector represents image characteristics, and vectors are stored in the index. At search time, the query is converted to vectors using the same process, and the KNN function simply needs to find similar vectors for image matching. This concept, vectorization with KNN, really opens up search beyond just text, as you can represent images, sounds, and different things using multiple faceted vectors. The next feature we'll need is the ML Commons plugin. Last year, Amazon OpenSearch Service added support for the ML Commons plugin, which provides a set of common machine learning algorithms through the transport and REST API calls. You can also interact with the ML Commons plugin through piped processing language commands. Using the ML Commons feature in OpenSearch, we can incorporate machine learning algorithms, which are trained externally as part of the OpenSearch domain functions. ML Commons can also perform inferences, which is what we will use for semantic search. So, what is exactly semantic search? In semantic search, we encode the meaning and context of a keyword or a phrase. Here's an example of the difference. Semantic search on the left and keyword search on the right. If we take a look at this, here we have an example. User has input the phrase, do I need to buy anything extra to use with Xbox One S controller? This would be a user looking for questions and answers in a product database. On the right-hand side, we'll start with the keyword search results, and we have some highlighted keyword results here. We'll notice the first result, will this work without the adapter on a second-gen Xbox One controller? Probably is a decent match to the question that we actually asked. But as we look down this list of 10 results, notice that does and work comes up often, but the most important item, the Xbox, seems to be entirely left out of the rest of the results on the keyword search. On the other hand, on the semantic search side on the left, it looks like all of our results have Xbox in it. Many of them have Xbox controller. And so overall, look to be a much better match for the intended question that the user actually typed. This screenshot example is taken directly from a DIY workshop that we have available. Check out the QR code on the right-hand side here if you'd like to take a look and try it out for yourself. Let's take a deeper dive into how keyword search differs from semantic search. Keyword search uses an inverted index and allows us to quickly find the documents with the highest BM25 ranking. This is a TF-IDF-based score. But basic analyzers and tokenizers strip away much of the context and leave only the keywords without much of the meaning around them. On the other hand, semantic search codes text as numerical vectors, store the vector data, then run KNN search across vectors to find nearest matches. Notice the quality of results in the semantic search versus the keyword search results. Quality of the match depends on quality of the model and the training. You can train your own model, which is especially useful if you have a very specialized data set that is being searched, like industry-specific keywords, lots of industry-specific jargon, maybe medical terms, technical, etc. Notice again, we have that same kind of example, keyword search on the left. Does this work with Xbox? Of the top four results returned using the BM25 score and an inverted index, only one of those really is a direct match for the question we asked. Whereas in semantic search, using vector data and KNN, we can see that all four of the top four results are a good match for does this work with Xbox, the question we were asking. With that said, I'd like to talk a little bit about Neural Plugin. New to the OpenSearch open source project with version 2.5 is the Neural plugin. This plugin looks to fully automate all of the steps required for semantic search to work with your domain. During ingestion, the Neural plugin computes vectors from your text automatically. Then, during search, the Neural plugin computes the vector from your search text. There is no need to interact with SageMaker or KNN search even. The Neural plugin takes care of all of this so that you can simply deal with your text data. Notice that this is still in beta for open source project as of version 2.5, but we generally have planned to and make our open source features available in the managed service. Now let's take a deeper dive into how the Neural Search plugin works. First, you create an index mapping with the appropriate fields and specify which fields will be vector-based. You do this through the regular OpenSearch REST API, and the index mapping is stored within OpenSearch Core as usual. You then index documents through the OpenSearch API. The Neural Search retrieves the mapping from OpenSearch Core, then sends the necessary fields to the ML Commons plugin to compute the vectors. And then the Neural Search uses KNN plugin to store the vector data in OpenSearch indexes. Then, when you go to search, simply send your search data request to the OpenSearch API, and the Neural Search plugin will pick up and transform your request using the same ML Commons plugin as before. Then the transform text is sent to KNN plugin for the actual search, and OpenSearch Core will return the results back to your client through the API, simplifying all the steps necessary to use semantic search in OpenSearch. Thank you for joining me for this session today, and be sure to check out the AWS Data Lakes and Analytics page to learn more.